reach you every Saturday at 11 a.m. on Sati, Awaken to the Present, where we talk about mindfulness, the art of living, and how we can enhance our life by bringing meditation and mindfulness into our life to enhance our life in a positive manner. Of course, as promised, I've invited to join us today with me on this live somebody who's very well known, somebody you love, somebody who y'all embrace with a lot of love, none other than Ottara Gunawardana. And I'm here to connect with Ottara Gunawardana, one of Sri Lanka's most recognized and successful entrepreneurs, female entrepreneurs who made it on her own, and somebody who has built her own brand, who has brought success to her over the years. And she will be talking today not about entrepreneurship, she'll be talking to us about mindfulness, how mindfulness as a lifestyle, how she has brought meditation as a lifestyle into her life to enhance her life and to currently trying to connect with Ottara Gunawardana to talk to her, of course, about how instead of letting your life pass you by, mindfulness, the art of living, and how this experience can enhance our life. So let me see how I can. I'm waiting for Tara. At the same time, I must remind you that every Saturday at 11 a.m. we have been talking about mindfulness, meditation with the Venerable Olande Ananda, as well as other gurus from India who have been bringing to us this positive aspect, meditation, how you can live in the moment, live in the present, and also how the time you start until you go to sleep, and how conscious you can be in your sleep and bring positive to your lifestyle. I'm finding it difficult to connect with Ottara at the moment. At the same time, I remind you all that you all can send us your questions. Continue to send us your questions here, and how you can be mindful of your everyday activities, how you can live in the present moment, and try to embrace the art of meditation as your relationships with your family, as well as your loved ones, your friends, and how meditation can not only help you with the outside world, but when you look within, how that could enhance your to uplift her life. Of course, Ottara Gunawardana.
Hi,
Hi,
sorry, I am a bit late,
lovely.
I think.
No, I think
Hi.
everyone's waiting for you. They have a lot of questions for you. And I had a little bit of time to explain about the program, and you need no introduction. But of course, we are talking about something different today, not about entrepreneurship. I promised it's not about entrepreneurship. So, how are you doing this morning?
I'm doing good, thank you. Thank you for having me on your program.
We've been honored, and we've always been happy to host you, Otara. You've been a trendsetter. You've been a positive influencer. You've proven that when you put your heart and mind into something, that you can make it big. again, let's not go back to your success as an entrepreneur, but as someone, as an individual, as a person, when you look within, how you have enhanced your lifestyle. So mindfulness as a practice, meditation. So let's start off there. What do you do? What is mindfulness and meditation to you?
Well, you know, I mean, it's something that's come into my life in the last few years. I didn't really do a lot of you know, meditation or connecting with spirituality too much during my time in Dell and during my business time. I wish I had, but I would have had a lot less stress. But you know, everything comes to you at the right time that it's meant to come to you. So yeah, it's actually a lot. I've been practicing it a lot more. You know, to be, it's everything is really about ourselves and about who we are within. We spend a lot of time, you know, running around. It's all, you know, social media, so many things to tell us today. Or influence us to act in different ways, or you know, buy certain things, or things. I think that if you don't know who we are within, and if we are not peaceful and happy within, and that I think is where everything starts, and that I think is where a lot of the problems of the world, a lot of the problems of our country. Everything begins because of that. That creates what happens around us. So everything that happens around us that we like or we don't like is really a reflection of who we are as a society, who we are as a. You know, if what's happening around. You see some things that you don't like, or you know that you're still a part of it. So really, all we can do individually, all we need to be happy within, to be content within, and that alone will change so much on the outside. You know, to create a world and a country that we would like, or we like to see. Maybe some people are very happy with what's happening, and then that's fine too.
as long as you're happy.
Yeah. Loving yourself, and that's not in a, you know, for a long time, I was told about this self-love and loving yourself, you know, and I could never understand it really, and it's really not the thing to do. You know, it takes a lot of practice and a lot of understanding, and a lot of things that you need to do. And you know, a lot of it also comes with having a mind that doesn't wander. You know, our minds are really the cause of a lot of pain, a lot of suffering. Anyone who follows Buddhism, the Buddhist teachings, will also know that, you know, about the suffering and how that's really the one of the major parts of why we are sad, or why we suffer really, and to remove the suffering that we face each day. And that suffering is not about pain in your body. It's not about you know, the suffering that you, if somebody scolds you or the anger you have, but it's really about anything, right? If you want something and you can't get it, suffering. If you you know, somebody in your life may cause you suffering in things like that, the craving of things that we have on a day-to-day basis, whatever it may be. So yeah, I mean, so The last year also has been much greater focus for me. Things happen, I think, in your life that take you down a path that you're meant to go on. So I just go with the flow and follow the path. So I've been practicing meditation a lot.
Right.
That because it has helped me during this lockdown time to be so peaceful and so accepting of the situation and be for 2 months. So
that's
so,
something
know,
that's something I'd like to talk to you about, Otara. But before that, you did mention something about our aspirations, our wants, our cravings, our expectations, which make us unhappy. Now, we want all these in order for us to be happier, because our expectations are always about what we want that will make us happy, that we hopes and need requirements, and that all those expectations in the process, they make us miserable, they make us unhappy. We're not content, as you said. But how do we define ourselves at a day and age when you did mention all this time about how people try to be what the society wants us to be, or something we believe is what we need to be like? But how do we look within? What are your most simple, let's talk about a 5 or 6 practices that from our life.
It's all very easy to say. It's not easy to do. It's but once you get there, it's like one day like a light switch goes on, and it's like, oh my gosh, like I've never felt so much peace and so much calm and happiness within, you know. And it doesn't mean that you're always in that space, because it's about being able to handle things that happen, the good, the bad, the challenges and everything that happens around you, but still handle it with a sense of peace and calm,
right,
and not let it affect you deeply, you know, inside. It's not an easy path, but it's certainly worth it. I do meditate every day somehow. I of course, you know, a day or two here or there, I may miss it, but I try my best to do it every day for half an hour. If I can, I would love to do 1 hour, but sometimes it's not possible, and sometimes it's 20 minutes. But, you know, it's not about also setting a time or a goal. You do it as much as you can. I try to do it twice a day, maybe another 15 minutes or 20 minutes later in the day. I mean, that's my practice. It doesn't mean that everybody has to have the same, or that's the right one. I went through a difficult situation, a challenge. You know, it's time for you to start them. The meditation, which I had been doing,
is that what triggered you to embrace mindfulness very, very seriously?
No, I mean, I have been, following, I've been quite spiritual the last few years, like just exploring things. We're just a small speck in a very big universe, and that we're here, just on this earth to contribute and to do good and to do to give, to care, to love, and then we just leave. That's really all we're here for. But it's all our egos and all our wants and desires and our greed that make us suffering for so many, and including ourselves. I couldn't even sit for like 5 or 10 minutes. So it was so difficult, but then the more and more you practice, the more and more then it becomes 15 minutes, 20 minutes, meditations sessions for 1.5 hours, which I really love, which I'm so sad that I can't go for at the moment. I know he has it on Zoom, but for me it hasn't been quite the same on Zoom. But I used to love to go to his center and do the meditation
And we
with
continue to talk
him.
to Venerable Olanda Anandahimi on Sati every week.
Yeah,
Yes.
well, yeah, he's, and then the walking meditation as well, which is mindfulness, where you're most of the time we're not, when we even when we walk and even when we do other acts, we're not very mindful of what we do. And really, it's we're not very mindful a lot of the time about what we do. And mindfulness and keeping your and basically to still your mind is really what's also really important, because we have a very, very all these scenes and episodes of things that sometimes are not even, not sometimes, most of the time are not even stuff. And so meditation helps you to really still your mind, and to make it calmer, and to give you greater awareness and greater consciousness, and it opens your mind to seeing things more clearer as well. And sometimes things that were you thought were good are really not good. Sometimes things, that you didn't notice were good, you suddenly see as, oh my gosh, it's amazing. And really, it's really it's your mind that causes to the everything is to do with your mind, because everything, if we no matter who's in your life, no matter who's not in your life, no matter and it can be family, relationship, girlfriend, boyfriend, husband, no matter what, you have to be happy within yourself. It's not anyone else that can make you happy. It's not any, and even when you're lonely, it's because there's something wrong. There's something not right within you. So you should be happy, even if you're alone for 10 days, you should be able to be content. If this too shall pass. But I'm happy. I'm content. No matter what I have or don't have, I am happy now. And it doesn't. It's not related to how much you have or money or material things. It's irrelevant. You can have all the money in the world, and you can still be so unhappy inside, and so hurtful inside, and so painful inside. Have this, we'll be happy. If we have that, we'll be happy. If I have more money, I'll be happy. If I have another car, I'll be happy. It's really, none of that makes you happy. It's you're always then wanting the next thing or the other thing, or it takes very, very, very little. It doesn't take anything for you to be happy or content. If you don't have it within you, it's there's no point in having a lot of things. If you have a lot of things and you're stressed and hurtful. It's all within us, really. This is where the happiness, the content, the peace, everything is within us. You just have to tap in and be able to get there, to find it, and it doesn't mean you asked earlier about like the wanting things that I want, that I would like to do, but it doesn't become like like a big attachment and a big craving that then causes you suffering, because I can't, I want to have, I want to do whatever, and then I can't. But it's a
But
process,
it's
and
about
it's one where,
managing yourself every day at a time. And talking about detachment, loneliness, and relationships during the period of lockdown, and slowly we're moving, we're easing out of this. predicts that world over there will be a psychological impact. They're talking about the future, but right now we see the psychological impact on so many of us, you, me, everyone. But you've spoken about how you managed that through your practice of meditation. First, we have to get used to being under curfew, and now a new normal that we never was expecting. Again, we come back to our expectations. So you say it's not about not having expectations. It's about being detached, too greedy about what you want. Tell us your experience about these 2 months. What did you do from the beginning of the day until you wind up the day?
You know, I've been really busy. I don't know what I'm doing for the day. But the days fly by. So, you know, of course, I do a little bit of work from home and communicating with my teams. And, you know, I do. But it doesn't take a lot of time of my day. And I just make sure every day, like I make sure I do my meditation. I do my every other day. I do my yoga. I do workout as well. Mm. So I do my workouts as well on every one thing that this, now there are several things I think that this situation has taught us, which I hope many can see and change, you know, their lifestyles. But it is so important to be healthy and to have a good immune system. Because the majority of people who've got the sickness or who get it, not only this, but you know, when you get sick, it's because your immune system is low, or because you're always on other medication, or you're not healthy, or you're not eating well. You're eating a lot of junk food, a lot of processed food, and you know it is not good. We look at all these ads and get so taken up with all this, the way that we are taught to. For you, you know, eating unhealthy things is not good for you, and that doesn't mean like you have to be ultra clean in what you eat, you know. But I mean, but you can indulge once or twice, but you know, on and off, not once or twice, on and off.
Yes.
But, but you know, on the whole, it's so important, and you know, that also helps you. You're not, when you don't spend time outdoors, you know, getting vitamin D from the sun, spending time on the grass. You know how when you stand on the grass and you stand on earth with bare feet, you connect to the earth, and that also gives you a lot of it changes the your system to make it more healthy, more positive. So those are all things, and those are all things that we used to do in the past, but you know, we've all lost that sort of connection with the earth, with Mother Nature, with the healthy living. You know, so important to be healthy, you know, as well, and along with that, if you can practice, you know, to be mindful, to practice meditation. I mean, I can tell you, it's so helpful, and it is not a thing that is out of the box and out, like something way out there. It has been taught to us over the years, you know, to create greater awareness within ourselves, to connect more to nature, to connect to ourselves more, and you know, you'll see a greater change in society as well. I mean, you know, there's so much hate and so much negativity on social media. Everybody goes through different things at different times. But, and I, you know, maybe in my time I've done things like that as well. But, you know, you just see how people respond, what they say. Passion to how much, you know, what they feel inside. You know, so like
is,
that I
is,
mean
is, sorry negativity that also pushes us to a lot of various states of mind, from depression to loneliness to anxiety, nervousness. Family, our loved ones, sometimes we end up ruining our relationships because of certain negative aspects that we embrace into our life. How do you manage that, especially when we talk about depression and anxiety? Some fear talking to another about it. For the experience at some stage in our life.
Of course, yeah, we all do. You know, when I was 20, when I had just started Odell, I had severe anxiety attacks. I'm not even sure how I got it. Maybe some form of stress, and I had severe anxiety attacks. And you know, I had to go through the process of figuring out. And at that time, I did have to take tablets and things, which I don't do now. I take medication, we all go through it, and it's something that, you know, it's all to do with the mind again. My mind used to, you know, has to think the strangest things, and it's all how your mind, you know, takes you into the within and clean your mind and learn to still your mind, because it's what, you know, it's your mind, like I said earlier, that just wanders everywhere. And brings you such pain and suffering. And you know, also thinking about the past, thinking about the future, all that is also absolute stress. And it doesn't mean you don't plan or you don't have ideas for the future, but all we have is now, like, is this moment, right? All we have is now. And if you're not happy now, every moment is all we have. And you know, otherwise, imagine 1 minute ago I was sad, and you know, like and if you're like that all the time, you know, you live a very, very unhappy life. So is all sort of you know, what we've been being taught is, like, we have to have this now, that now, but really not a lot is enough control. We have to sort of go with the flow of a lot easier. I think one thing also that we can say with what's happened now is that really we're not in control, are we? We're not in control of anything. We just think we are. Our egos think we are in control, but we're not. Because nature and the whole you know, universe is just so much of that we can destroy all of that and have everything, you know, for now. And you can see that we are nothing, really. We have been brought to our knees, kept in our homes, and kept in our homes, hopefully to find ourselves and improve ourselves. So yeah, sorry, I strayed from your original question. So I've been, you know, meditating, doing yoga, working out. You know, I think it's one of the healthiest things you can eat, with all the vegetables, you know, and that you can, you know, make so many nice things with. As you know, things have been difficult, to not easy to find as well, which has made things a lot simpler as well. And
homegrown, you know, simple food.
Oh yeah, homegrown. A lot of people, including me, doing home gardening, being not so and less dependent on the outside system, and you know, so that we can live our lives simply, as self-sufficiently as possible. That is where that is also where I think a lot of issues come, because we are so connected to a system, we are so used to certain comforts, that then not having them all of a sudden, you know, puts us in a place of absolute, like, you know, like we're lost, you know. But really, connected to a lot of wants and needs of this system, you know, we are indebted to a lot of people, and we have to follow certain things that we are told to do that we don't really need to do or should be doing. So, you know, once you do meditation, once you get more mindful, and you know, you're aware of you know, like we're not aware of our mind and how many positive thoughts you have, how many negative thoughts you have, and every time you have a negative thought, you change it to a positive thought. If you just do that for a few days, you know, after a while, negative life creates negative outcomes, and it creates life, no matter what, and it really changes what happens outside you, you know, as well. And that is really the thing of being more mindful about how you, and it's not easy to do. And also in meditation, you know, your mind wanders everywhere, and you know, you never.
Certainly.
Black mind, you know.
Yes.
So.
But it is the path.
You know, I'm thinking of this. Let it go. I'm thinking of this. Let it go. I'm thinking of this. Let it go. You know. And then slowly you have some time where you're not really thinking of anything, and it's just stilling your mind brings so much change and so much, you know, peace and acceptance of things, and you react differently, you see the world differently, you see your neighbors differently, you see your family differently, your relationships, a lot of that changes, because a lot of it becomes so unimportant, really, of, you know, the way you've been acting, the way you've been reacting. A lot of things that you've been doing, you see what's wrong, what you need to change, you know, because it have, you know, judgment for others. Everybody's going through different things in their lives at different times. So you can't really judge people. You can't really, you know, go to a lot of telling people what they should do is also our own egos thinking that's how they should act, you know. So feedback as well. And, you know, it's fine as long as I know that I'm doing what I think is right, that I'm mindful, that I'm not harming anyone, that I just want a country and a planet that where we don't harm animals and protect our environment, because we need that for a healthy lifestyle, for a healthy you know, planet for you know, like, for example, I didn't see what was wrong in going to the zoo, and I used to work there when I was a child. But I know now, you know, that, you know, I was in an environment where I didn't see that the animals lived in a cage all their life, you know, and I see now how wrong that is. I mean, not now, I've seen it now for several years.
And now, like, to be caged and locked down. Yeah,
I hope more and more have realized, and you know, like, zoos and all that exist just for our entertainment, and because, you know, I don't know how as humans we have been brainwashed to think that it's okay, and a lot of it is at the base of it is profit and money, and we will be told so many stories, we will be told so many things. Almost 99% of that comments that are negative are those who profit from the zoo, or those who have personal benefits from the zoo. And that is the case with a lot of things to do with animal slaughter, to do with, you know, and, you know, it is a personal process that you go through, each one, you know, to know Oh my gosh, look at me eating a cow. Look at this. Look at what I'm a part of. Look at the suffering I'm causing that cow. You know, like, and you know, and then you think, I don't want to be a part of that anymore. You know, I can live very happily without eating, you know, without. Not so, you know, even when I you know, as you know, I do a lot of awareness and things on my pages, so it's not for me to tell people stop eat now, you know, like, and I don't want to be a part of that anymore, because being mindful is also being not hurting others, not being harmful, not you steal your mind, the more you see all that.
Yes. You surround yourself with nature, although most of us may have forgotten that, as you said, we are part of this bigger picture, of this bigger field of energy. Talking about connecting to a higher power, the universe, seeking greater consciousness, certain meditation practitioners, but today you are embracing it as your lifestyle. You built a business out of the boot of your car, and then you climbed the corporate ladder, but it didn't take much for you to realize that there is happiness within too. We have all of us running behind, as we spoke at the beginning of this program, so much of aspirations, which brings anxiety, depression. This is the corporate world. You're expected to be someone, to do something, to do certain things that you are asked to by your parents as a kid, or when you grow up, you believe that is what you have to be. And then we forget the nature. Then we talk about meditation and connecting to a higher power. But all this clashes, and there's also the modern concept of law of attraction. I believe this is something you'd be able to talk about too, how we bring positivity, how we
so, you know, it's not that you can't do all those things, but we have to be more conscious in the decisions we take, in the actions we take. We think is for the benefit of the greater good of society, of a society, but actually a lot of it is not, because you know, a lot of the other things that we do, even personally, we think is helping a lot of people, but why, after all these years, why is there such a great divide of so many poor, so many who can't eat, and then so many who and a very, very small percentage that are okay and can and don't have that struggle? You know, if we have all been doing the right thing, this great divide should not be there at this time. If we are all so amazing in how we have developed, this great divide should not be do that. Yes, we should, but then with all that we've done, you know, and you know, it's time, this is the wake up call for all of us to bring this change. Everything we do, we need to see differently to do for the collective whole of everyone, and for the benefit of everyone, and that is always includes animals as well. You cannot exclude them. They're not outside of us, they're not outside of our planet, they're not outside of our lives. And to do with nature as well. It's not outside of us. It's responsible for all of it. If not, we will, you know, we will never have this happiness and this peace, and you know that, and the justice that we think everyone in this earth and planet and country needs. And and also, you know, we give our power away to a lot of people that we think can help us to solve this, help us to bring, well, whatever we want for our country or for the humanity in us. So all that you can change and you can help improve by being more mindful, by being more by stilling your mind, and then you see a lot of things, you know, like a lot differently, and you can see how you can to change the greater collective consciousness of things around you, and to give a better life to people and animals in our country and planet. And so it doesn't mean that you don't, you know, you don't have big ideas of a business to do or a business to run, or, you know, but you make choices differently that don't harm the planet, that don't harm, and that you're aware it's not all about, it doesn't mean that it's the right thing for you on certain things that you eat, on certain things that you buy, you know, and even when I ran, Odell, you know, it's a different time for me than now. I also didn't see a lot of things that I know now. But, you know, I was always conscious about not having too many sales, not having too many. And it was sometimes an argument I used to have as well, because sometimes I used to be pushed to do it. But because I didn't want to push people to buy things that they didn't want, just to get profit or just to increase sales. And then, you know, when you become a public company and then, you know, things start changing, I never wanted to do it, like to keep a lot of, you know, people, you also want to increase your sales and you want to push people to buying things all the time, and people, you don't need stuff all the time, you know, people need to make that decision on their own and come and buy what they want. So this is also the change that I'm very happy with, this one t-shirt for a month. I don't need, you know, five cars anymore. I'm very happy with this one simple car I have now. So that is the change. You know, retail and a lot of things, companies that were in that business of pushing people to buy a lot of stuff. So that's because people were getting more conscious that, you know, how it harms the environment, how it harms retail as a example, but, you know, it also goes to the food you eat, the animals you hurt, you know, all that. So that change was definitely happening, you know, before as well. And
I think we should have a separate discussion to talk about minimalistic lifestyle, minimalism, and how I promise our viewers that I will give them an opportunity for their questions. I had a post running throughout the past 2 days for them to send us questions, and there have been many, so please allow me to take a few questions for you. Somebody on the live says you are the most generous person. Very kind of them to join us on the live and to share, and I'm sure this discussion will benefit their lifestyle. From India, there is a question. Wow. He's watching us live. Yes. How do you remain mindful or positive when things around you work? I think we could do justice to his question.
That's what I said earlier, right? When you can have peace and stillness within you, the chaos that happens around you, you don't really connect to. You know, this is just currently what it is. This too shall pass. Better things are coming. Individually, so there are some things that may happen that may harm, but that may not may harm, that may affect me individually as well, but I know that as a greater picture, greater change, I know that things are going to get better for the whole. The chaos, you don't connect with the negativity. I hardly watch the news because I just can't stand the negativity and the constant, you know, the constant talk of the sickness and the this and the that, and you know, it just it puts you more in that spin, and you need to take yourself, you know, out of that. And there are so many certain things, you know, which we don't really need to do. So when if you can get to a place where you have the peace within you, and like I said, having the peace because it's not possible in a human. I mean, you know, I may have a day tomorrow where I cry about something because I'm, you know, it's really hurt me or something, but that's okay. I cry for 10 feet and I don't need to carry it within me. I just need to, you know, focus on the bigger picture, and I, you know, this too shall pass. But when you have that awareness, and when you have those to get yourself out of those situations, that then keeps you in a place of peace and calm, that you don't really become a part of the chaos and part of the you know, the sort of negativity that happens outside. And if we all have to change to be more positive and grateful for the day before I go to sleep. I make sure I do it every day. Because it's not something, actually something I learned from Oprah to do, about, you know, being grateful, being about gratitude. Beautiful sunshine today and the bright blue skies. And, you know, even though I say it, it's not. When there's something that's bothering you in your life, and there's something that's, you know, not quite what you want it to be, it's not easy. It's not easy to your life to making it more peaceful, more calm, more accepting, and the decisions you take as well, and the way you react to situations, the way you react to my dog is running behind.
It's nice to have him around.
Certain things, she keeps barking as well, Lola.
Oh, that's Lola.
Stressed and, you know, and being sad or being, you know, being negative. And so, you know, thinking positive. I mean, you just take like 2 days, like today, tomorrow, to just, but you have to be, you know, to be, to changing that thought to being positive, and the more you do it, you'll see an amazing change. It's an amazing change. You will realize how much negative thoughts you have a day as well. And you know, you attract, like you said, you attract. If you think negative, you attract more negative things. If you think positive, you attract anyone else. Like, it's you who's attracting the things that happen into your life. So you can change that by changing the way you think, and changing the way you respond, and changing the way you know, with the path that we are on, that is really which is meant for us. We are not in control of to go into business. I was, for some reason, I don't know what that reason is now, yet. Maybe there's some reason for it, maybe there isn't, I don't know. But, you know, I'm a biologist. I'm a biologist who loved animals, who started a business, which I made it a public company.
Is that something you wanted? I spoke about law of attraction, and that this is something world over. Oprah what you believe in, what you think,
Yeah.
what you believe in, and what
You
you
are,
want.
yes.
Yes. So is
You
that
are,
what you
yeah.
wanted when you went there?
No,
I'm
but
sorry.
that's
There are other questions too, but I think I keep asking my
No, but
questions.
that's why I said that some of comes to you, so you just have to follow your path, and you know, some of it comes to you, which you don't know why it comes to you. I had no interest to start a business. I had no interest to grow a company, and you know, to the business because I wanted to raise money to help animals. And you know, and at the root of it, yes, was my love to protect nature and save animals. And that's then eventually what I've come back to today. And you know, yes, everything is what you attract into your life. You know, if you think I'm going to lose that, I think I'm going to lose that, or I think I'm going to lose that, you will lose it. It will go, you know. Whereas if you think, no, I think that will grow, that will come back, that's what it's meant to be, and it will come back, it will go that way, but only if it's meant for you, and only if it's what's right for you, and only if it's what's right for your highest good. It doesn't mean, you know, you say I want, this is a bad example because we always use you, but maybe you might get one or something, but you know, it also has to be what's right and what's consciously, you know, possible, and what's right for you, and you know, what's not greedy, and you know that type of thing as well. And everything has to be with a good heart. You know, I used to always lead with my heart, and I still do. And I never agreed with people who didn't believe that. But you know, again, even though I don't agree, doesn't mean I don't. I judge them. You know, it's just different people with different thoughts. But you know, it's so important, especially now, for us to open our hearts, connect with our hearts, and lead with our hearts, because that we need to change in the months and years ahead. It's a way of life we need to change for the greater good of many more people, many more animals, and for the greater good of the environment, which also affects us. I think we really need to open our hearts more and connect with our hearts, and we need to make choices that we is okay with our hearts, not with our heads. We can use our heads, but we have to eventually ask our heart, is this picture the true decision? Like, is this the right thing to do for the greater good of all? You know, and where without any agendas, without any personal agendas, you know, and I think that's where the change is. That's what the world needs. That's what our country needs. And that can also only come with more people wanting that change, because system now, it's we who are keeping it like that. If you don't like it, it's we who can change it. If you like the system of the way the fast food is in this country, it's us who's creating it, not anyone else. You know, like we are contributing. Maybe so, all those things. It's us who's doing it, not anyone else. So we need to change individually. Mm-hmm.
Yes, because I must be mindful of how much of your time we take on this program, and be conscious of not taking too much of your time.
It's already 12.
Yes, but I'm going to, if you may allow me to read a few. I'm from Australia, a Sri Lankan living there. What are the changes you see in yourself after including mindfulness as a practice in your life? That's one question. And then I take the other. How much has your life changed since incorporating mindfulness? And then we have, how do you mindful mean to you? What are your future plans And then there is I think I'm very bad with technology. And then there is did you practice mindfulness while at but again there is another I can't see the name, of course. She wants to know five basic practices that you recommend. I think that's a good way to wrap up the discussion too, with all these questions, because everyone wants tips, practices, and what you think they should do. For someone who's a beginner, do you concentrate on your breath, or do you concentrate on what's going on there? Do you a lot of things they would like to know. And somebody asks about the power of the now. I think they're
All you have
referring
is
to,
now.
yes.
We don't have tomorrow, we don't have yesterday, we only have now. Yeah. So you
So
have to
I
be
think,
happy and peaceful and joyful now. Not easy to do.
right.
But yeah. And yeah,
Yes.
the other question, I mean, just start. Like, I've had a is ready, the teacher will appear. When you're ready for something, your teacher will come, and whoever that may be, it doesn't mean one teacher, or it doesn't mean, it can be even a friend, it can be even even a guru, or it can be even a yoga teacher, or whoever. But when you're ready for to make this change, and to take if you take the decision to that you want to change this, and you want to grateful for that has come into my life, and it came to me with a, like I said earlier, with something that was very difficult in my life, that I had, a challenge with, and I had to manage that. So that's and so I can only be thankful for that now. But and the torture we do for these animals, I mean, it's not good, and you see it all the time, even internationally still. So yeah, I mean those are the few things that I can
Right.
recommend. And have a routine. You have to have a routine, like a daily routine, which I think you need to stick to. Prayer is also good, but and a lot of this is just internal work, and you can do it in your home. You can do it. You have one place in your home that you can do it. For me, Buddhism has the understanding. I was brought up a Buddhist, and my parents, my grandmother and my mother used to take me to temple, and I used to follow a lot of the practices and the prayers, and I never really understood the actual, the actual teachings of the Dhamma. And that I started to learn, like, this year. To learn about it, and that anyway, anyone who follows any religion, I would suggest, because it is just a way of life. It's not a, as it's not a religion. It's just it teaches you a way of life, a way of mindfulness, a way of using living your life, so that in which will help. That we are looking for, and that we need really, the peace, the love, the compassion, that is, it's just a, it's just a way of life. It's just a path that you can just, learn about. It doesn't mean you have to stop your other prayers or anything like that. Those are the things that have helped me, and I hope it helps you, but I recommend it highly. And I think for me has been so much easier, because I had been venturing down that path, and it's made it so much easier for me to cope with, to handle. And the life, our life ahead is going to be very different to the way to what we've known. We may try and struggle and get back, try to get back to what we were doing, the way we were living. But I don't think it's, I think change is coming. And, you know, and like I believe it's a good change will come eventually. But, you know, it's a change that change has to happen within us as well. So it's, you know, and this will definitely help, you know, help you. And I know it's helped me, so I can only say that it'll help you as well. And, you know, it'll help our society. It'll help the greater consciousness you know, the greater.
Up with some one of your fans, our friends, saying thank you for inspiring us. So that's the comment that has just come in. The power of the now, living in the moment, mindfulness as a lifestyle. This is what we discussed about, and constantly we hear that when we really badly want something, all the universe conspires you to have it. And you did mention while giving us your tips that when you're ready, a teacher will appear. So with all that in mind, I must thank you very much for taking time to join us on Sati, Awaken to the Present. We join our viewers, our friends, every Saturday at 11 a.m.